Good morning, dear students of class 8. We are back for you from St. Mary's School, Nagina, to study geography for 8th class. Today you will be getting the writing portion of lesson number 1. This lesson was already made you understood in previous videos. We have shown you how to represent geographical sea features on Earth. So I hope you understood well this chapter. If you have any query, ask in the comment box, we will solve your queries. Before beginning the writing portion, let me give you an important exercise. You can see this figure is there, different settlement pattern is showing. You all are requested to draw this diagram. This is very important diagram, it can come for your unit test. So you all have to draw carefully. These are different types of settlements are there, linear, dispersed and nucleated. So like this diagram you have to make in your notebook. Then let us come on our writing portion. Before writing portion, let me tell you one reminder that points remember also are important for your learning. So you better learn them, no need to write in notebook. Just learn them for your coming exam so that it will be helpful for you. Now, we are moving on exercises. Let us see. Exercises are very important. You all have to write all these exercises in notebook. And here are questions. Question number 1, it is saying what are the different ways of showing a scale on a map. Question number 2, what is the difference between large scale and small scale map. And question number 3, what is topographic map, as well as question number 4, what is spot height and how it is shown on a topographic map. So I'll be showing you this question so that you can write, and then only answers I will be guiding you with. In between, I'll show you one more time questions. So that questions you all can see while opening notebook, while opening your books. Then, what is spot height and how it is shown on a topographic map? So all these answers for first question, answer is on page number 1. For second, you have to show and see in writing way. I have written for you. So third answer also is on page number 1, second column, you will find it. Then what is spot height and how it is shown in topographic map, it is on page number 2, second column. Let us move for first answer directly. You are well familiar with the question. Question was, what are the ways of showing a scale? What are the different ways of showing a scale on a map? So can you see carefully, answers on page number 1, first column, when you will open, you see this red dot. They are showing by a statement, by graduated straight line known as linear scale, bar scale or graphic scale. Then by the representative fraction RF, that is the ratio between the map distance and the ground distance. Up to here your first answer is over. For second answer you have to write, telling you, see carefully. Question is, what is the difference between large scale and small scale map? Large scale map, comma, like tourist map, comma, shows smaller areas on a large paper, while a small scale map, comma, like an atlas map, comma, shows large areas of the earth on a relatively small piece of paper. So that is your second answer. I hope it's clear for you. Third question is, what is topographic map? So topographic map is here given on page number 1, second column, red lines. A large scale map showing both man-made and natural features is called a topographic map. Up to this much only you have to write. This is your answer third. Now then we are moving on answer fourth. Question fourth for you was, what is a spot height and how it is shown on a topographic map? See students, spot height, the height of any particular point is called spot height. This is first part of the answer. Then how it is shown in topographic map? On a topographic map, spot height is shown by a black dot making the spot and a number giving the height of the spot above the sea level. So all this is here. Up to here four answers are over. Now our next questions are on page number 9. Let us see these questions all together once. One by one I will read all the questions and then you can see. Question number 5th is, what are contours? what is their color on a topographic map? So color is mentioned here, brown color. In line form they are shown. Second part I have written here in book only. You can also for time being write, but at home you have to do later in your copy very neatly and in very nice manner all these questions. Question 6 is, what do contour line tell us about the slope of a line? So this is on page number 4, first column. I'll tell you where it is. I'll show you when after this slide. Then 7th question is, how is the contour pattern of a mountain different from that of a plateau? So that is page number 4, first and second column, both we'll use for them. And question number 8 is, name two kinds of feature that can be shown on by contours touching each other. So this is col and saddle. For question 8, you can write answer here only. Col and col is first part and second. They are asking two features. First feature is col, second feature is saddle. So that much is for 8th answer. 9th answer, how do we know whether the water body shown on a topographic map has water or dry? So we have to, I'll give you in writing this answer. So you will see one by one slides. Let's see. Question 10 now. What is a settlement? Distinguish between temporary and permanent settlements. So this answer is on page 6, second column. And some page 7 also, first column. Then 11th, mention three things that encourage the growth of settlements in a particular site. So that also you will write answer, I'll give you in written. Question 12, what is a settlement pattern? Page number 7, second column, this part is there, second part. Name three types of settlement patterns that I already told you. That is nucleated or compact. And I told you dispersed or scattered, a line or linear pattern. So all these are there. Let me show you from answer number 5 onwards now. Coming on answer 5. Question was, what are contours? You all can pay attention. It's given here clearly. A contour is an imaginary line joining places which have same height above the sea level. This much is only the first part answer. Then what is their color on a topographic map? I have told you while showing question, I have told you their color on a topographic map is brown color and they are in line form. This much you have to write for this answer. Okay, now coming on answer 6. Question 6 was, do you remember question 6 what was? Question 6 was, what do contour line tell us about the slope of a line? And I told you it was on page 4 in first column. Answer is here. When contours are closely packed, the slope of a line is steep. When they are wide apart, the slope is gentle. So this is 6th. Answer over. Now question 7. What is the contour pattern of a mountain? How is the contour pattern of a mountain differ from that of plateau? Answer is on page number 4, first column and second column. Let us see on first column what it is. First column you all can see. Contours representing a mountain or a conical hill are nearly circular. Let me show you clearly more. Here it is. Contours representing a mountain or a conical hill are nearly circular. Then you can take, leave one line, take the second last, third last line, last word. The center of the innermost contour represent the peak. I have shown by bracket. Similarly, you can mark in book now and just tomorrow you can write in copy or today itself. Evening you can write in notebook. Okay. Don't forget to write in notebook. It's very necessary when school will reopen. I'll ask you, I'll not give you more time then. Now, some more portion is there. For mountain, it is clear. Contours showing a plateau are closely spaced at the steepy sloping margins. This much. Then some more is there. I have told you from previous column, contours showing plateau are closely spaced at steepy sloping margin. Then take from here the part encircled, encircled, encircled by the highest value contour represent the top of the plateau. Represent the top of the plateau. This is up to here. Answer 7 is over. I hope it's clear to you. Now coming on. Question number 8. Question number 8. I told you, I have shown you here only in the book. Name two kinds of feature that can be shown by contours touching each other. I told you it is col or col and saddle. Two options are there in this. Now coming on answer 9. Let us see what is answer 9. Question 9 is here. How do we know whether a water body shown on a topographic map has water or is dry? So this is like this. I hope it's clear all of you. Answer is here. If the shown water body on a topographic map is of blue color, I have underlined blue keep in mind, blue color, then it has water in it. And if it is shown by black color, I underline black color, you can also underline it in notebook, then it does not have any water in it. Like this, answer 9 is over. Okay, moving on, answer 10. Question 10, do you remember? Question 10 was, what is a settlement? Two part answer. So first part, what is a settlement? A settlement is any kind of dwelling where people live. This is first part. Second, distinguish between temporary and permanent settlement. So here it is. Temporary settlements are those that are occupied for a short time. Then abandoned permanently. This is on page number 6 only, second column. Temporary settlements are those that are occupied for a short time and then abandoned permanently for a long period. Example, the cave. The cave is here, na last. Up to here only answer is there, the cave. And it is example. For an example, you can write the cave. This is first part showing you temporary. Now coming on page number 7. On page number 7, you will get permanent portion. They are asking, na, distinguish between temporary and permanent settlement. So permanent settlement portion is here, permanent settlements. Then cut these two words, no need of such settlements again. Permanent settlements are not abandoned and remain continuously in use for many years. Example, a hut or a house. Like this, you can complete answer 10. Coming on answer 11 now. Do you remember, students, what is 11th question? 11th question, I told you that I will give you in return. Mention three things that encourage the growth of settlements in a particular area, particular site. So answer is here. Three things that encourage the growth of settlements at a particular site are fertile soil, moderate climate, various economic activities. So this is your answer number 11. Now last question of this short answers, give short answers now. Question was, what is the settlement pattern? Here's answer for you. The settlement pattern shows how buildings are arranged in a settlement. So this is first part answer. Second part of the question is asking, name three types of settlements pattern. I have told you before, you can take from here. The first one is given there only, nucleated or compact. Scattered or dispersed. In the picture itself you can see they have two names. When you will read this portion, you will get on page number 7, nucleated or compact. On page number 8, red lines it is given, red words, dispersed or scattered. And on page number 8 only, second column, linear or line form. So these are like this. Answer number 12 is over. This much you have to write. Coming on next portion now. What is our next portion? See clearly. So this is, study the figure 1.2 and answer the following. This figure is given on page number 3. When you will open this figure, you will get all the details. What are, read them carefully. So this is homework for you. You have to do it yourself, how much you can do, and ask me doubts if you have any doubts. Okay, so this is homework for you. This is very easy. Just see the back side and you will get all answers, I hope. Will be very clear to you. In 7th class also you have studied such sheets. Okay, if you will have a problem, I'll deal with it future. Now let me come on last exercise, that is on page number 10, C exercise. Choose the correct option. All are ready with pencil? Be ready with the pencil. First one, topographic maps show man-made and natural features. That is D option is correct for first. For second, the horizontal line drawn on a topographic maps are called northings. While studying the chapter, it was explained to you what are northings and what are eastings. While giving a 4-grid reference, we first secured the number of appropriate eastings. So easting is third answer, that is C option. The lines joining places equal height above the sea level on a map are what are contours. D option is correct. For fifth, closely spaced contour indicate fifth option. For fifth question, A option is correct, A steep slopes. Sixth question, what kind of features has a contour pattern shaped somewhat like an hourglass? I told you while studying answer, although we have seen col or saddle. Saddle option is not here, so col we can take, that is B option. In V-shaped contour pattern, a river valley narrow and points eastward. The river is from east to west. So the river is flowing from east to west. That is B option for seventh. Eighth, the topographic map, which areas are usually colored yellow? cultivated lands are usually colored yellow, so C option is correct. Which of the contour pattern represent a ridge? See carefully, students. Which one is representing? In this D option, you can see. When you will open your book, you will see clearly this full figure. So D option is correct here. Then, what kind of settlement does the picture show? So picture is alongside. You can go through this picture. So clustered form houses are there. So it is nucleated or compact. So like this, we have done our exercise. Wish you all the best. Study carefully. Complete these answers compulsorily in your notebook in neat and clean handwriting. Wish you all the best. Happy day. Good.